neurological symptoms. These are the main symptoms on those exposed immediate exposure. Now there are certain signs. What I told you is symptoms. But when you look at the patient, what are the signs? The most important sign was tachycardia. Tachycardia means heart rate is beating. Heart is beating fast. That was the important finding. And again, another important finding was they were air febrile. There was no temperature. Therefore, the patients were having high heart rate and also breathing rate is also rapid. Therefore, they are breathing rapidly and also heart rate was very high and they were all air febrile. Air febrile, there was no fever in these individuals at that point of time. Now, coming to, because at that point of time, it was not possible to do any other investigation. The priority was treat the patient. The large number of patients coming, they were to be treated immediately, and these are only the record retrospective analysis of the data of the Gandhi Medical College published by Dr. N.D. Misra. Now, coming to the subacute phase, that is from January to March 1985, I was asked by ICMR, I was in Chennai at that point of time, to take the pulmonary function equipment from Chennai and go to the Bhopal and start the studies on the gas victims. On that basis, I took the pulmonary function equipment from Chennai, brought it to Gandhi Medical College, I did the studies on the equipment. You see here, even after 3 months of exposure, see, the pulmonary symptoms were persisting. See, nearly, I told that initially, soon after exposure, nearly 98% of subjects has got breathless nerves. Now after 3 months, again nearly 81% has got breathless persisting. Similarly, cough was passing 84. Somewhere 95% has got immediate, and again 75% has cough persisting. That means even after 3 months of exposure, respiratory symptoms were persisting in these subjects. Now, the problem is, symptoms are there. Mere presence of symptoms doesn't mean that has produced any damage to the lungs. For that purpose, we have to do the investigations. Therefore, I did the pulmonary function test with the equipment I brought from Chennai. These are the results. You can see here, these are some technical words. I will explain what it is. See, these are some of the technical words that we use if you want. What does it mean is, when we are taking drug and expelling air, there are some values will be obtained. And also the volume that is expelled in first 1 second is also known as FEV1. These are some of the volume that is being expelled by the individuals. So you can see here, when compared to the, all the values has to be compared to the control values, normal predicted values. When compared with the normal values, both males and females, these two values, all these values are significantly lower. You can see a star here. See, these people should have had, see, let us assume that 3.9 liters, see, they had only 3.3. That means 600 mL difference. That was significant statistically. In females also it is like that. All these values were, that means those exposed to the gas, even after 3 months, the pulmonary function was significantly lower compared to the control subject. Therefore, in addition to having symptoms, they got also abnormal pulmonary function changes. Now what had happened is again, see again, you should know that at that point of time, the first question was asked was, this is a single massive exposure to the gas. Will it produce any permanent lung damage? There are different opinions were at that point of time. Some people are telling that it's only one time it has occurred for some time, nothing has happened hereafter. Some people are telling that no, it can occur. That lung damage can occur on a long-term basis. But we should have scientific basis for telling all these things. Again, 1985-87, I again took the bronchoscope from Chennai to Bhopal. This bronchoscope is an instrument we can see inside the lung. That is passed through the nose or throat, we can see inside the lungs and take the fluid from the lung. And this is analyzed and see what is happening in the lung. I did that study and I will show the results now. See, when we look at the cells, you see, normally also in the normal lung, there are certain types of trials. I am not going